talked about numbers and phrases in King James Bible, you know, history lesson. Pages more on God's word than numbers, these two pages here, and which should be very important to all of us. Probably all of it is in the last one we got. Thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, 2 Timothy 3, 15b. God's word is holy. Our text talks about the Bible being the holy word of God. When somebody says the Bible is just another book, that's profanity. The Bible is the breath of God. God breathed the Bible. This is the very word of the holy God of heaven. For a person to demean the Bible and not respect the Bible as being the word of God, holy, unique, divided, none other like it, one of a kind, for them to disrespect the Bible as the very word of and breath of God, that is profanity. When one tampers with the word of God, that's profanity. When one thinks it's written by men, that's profanity. If I say, I know God said it, but what I'm doing is tampering with the word of God. I'm taking what God has designated as holy, unique, divine, uncommon, making it common. Tampering with the word of God is profaning that which is holy, according to Revelations 22, 18, and 19. You must tamper with another book and correct it, but you'd better not tamper with God's word book. God pronounced judgment on profaning his holy book. The word of God, the Bible, that's why I don't want anything to do with some other perversion that corrects and changes and deletes part of the Bible. God gave us a perfect Bible for the English-speaking world in the King James, and I have too much fear of God to mess. I just thought that was a pretty good saying. Now, the King James Code is what I'm going to be talking about tonight. What the King James Code is not. The King James Code is not a private, secret language that only the elect are going to be able to interpret. It does not necessarily require sophisticated computers and software in order to discover the codes. However, a computer search is much easier and less time-consuming than a typical concordance search. What is the King James Code? King James Bible contains a system of numbers that are consistently linked with words or phrases in the scriptures. It is understood that the Bible can be comprehended on many levels. The more you study the scriptures and become accustomed to them, the more you understand the divine symbols of certain passages that you never saw before. These must always come as a product of divine revelation. Certain words and phrases take on a whole new meaning, never contradictory to any other passage in the scriptures. As you study, you begin to see also the numbers seem to have a certain relevance in the Bible. Each number will have its own symbolic meaning. Things associated with completion or perfection. Six, and so on. What the word has revealed is that what the Lord has revealed, word and phrase occurrences in the King James Bible follow this same pattern. If a word or a phrase is added or omitted, this ruins the pattern. Could it be that this is why God commanded us not to add or take away from his word? Deuteronomy 4:2. Add unto the word which I command you, neither shall ye diminish on that ye may keep the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command you. Revelations 22, 18 and 19. 18, for I testify unto every man that heareth the words and the prophecies of this book. If any man shall add unto these things, God shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book. Verse 19, and if any man shall take away from the words of this book and this prophecy, God shall take away his part out of the book of life and out of the holy city and from the things which are written in this book. An example of how the works is found in the phase Holy Spirit. This phase is found exactly 7 times in the King James Bible. This not only reveals the divine nature of the Holy Spirit, but also reveals to us that the Bible is a very unique book. It contains the very signature of God Himself, for it would be impossible for man to plan a book and a system of numbers in this fashion. Numbers are one of the few things in this world that can truly reflect the nature of God in several ways. First, numbers are infinite. We will never count the last number because it does not exist. Not only are they infinite in positive form, but in negative form as well. This perfectly describes a God who is eternal, a God who always was and always shall be. Numbers are constant. They never change. In this world, languages have changed. People have changed. The world itself is in a constant state of change, but numbers remain the same. 2 plus 2 always equals 4 and always will. There is no way it will change. Numbers are one of the few things, according to Revelation 21, that will accompany us from the world to the next. They are as eternal and infinite as our mighty God is. He uses numbers to describe all things in the new heaven and new earth. Sir Isaac Newton wrote, "We account the scriptures of God to be the most sublime philosophy. I find more sure marks of authenticity in the Bible than any profound history whatsoever. Worshipping God and the Lamb in the temple, God for his benefaction in creating all things, and the Lamb for his benefaction in redeeming us with his blood. But through the system of revealed truth, which this book contains is, like that of the universe, concealed from common observation, yet the labors of the centuries have established its divine origin and developed it all its order and beauty, the great plan of human restoration." George Washington stated, "It is impossible to rightly govern a world without God and the Bible. All who have come to America have before them the greatest opportunity ever, the opportunity to become part of the great kingdom of God. There is no other nation on this planet where the gospel is so freely accessible." It was the King James Bible that accompanied the Puritan leader John Winthrop and 700 settlers who came to the New World in 1630. It was the King James Bible that was used to establish the first churches in America. It was the King James Bible that was used to establish the first civil governments in the colonies. It was the King James Bible that led those brave patriots in rebellion against the tyranny of King George. It was the King James Bible that was the basis of our great law, the Constitution. It was the King James Bible that our president, George Washington, laid his hand upon to swear an oath to preserve and protect the Constitution. It was opened to Deuteronomy 28:1-58. All of chapter 28 was a blessing to our nation as long as we kept him in our hearts and in our country. But if we take him out of our lives, we will be taken over by other nations, and evil plagues shall be upon us. 1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. In 58, if thou wilt not observe to do all the words of the law that are written in this book, that thou mayest fear and scorn the fearful name of the Lord thy God. These two verses were written to Israel, so we could use them to show the God in the scripture of any nation, people, or group. Here is a quick reference guide to numbers in scripture and their symbolic meanings. This is not an exhaustive list, but it will give you some idea of the different ones. The number 1, unity, beginnings. The number 2, union, division, witnessing. The number 3, resurrection, divine completeness. Number 4, creation, worldliness. The number 5, grace, God's goodness, redemption, and the number associated with the rapture. The number 6, weakness of man, evils of Satan, manifestation of sin. The number 7, completeness, spiritual perfection. Number 8, new birth, new creation, new beginning. The number 9, fruit of the Spirit, fruit bearing. The number 10, the Word of God, law and responsibility, kingship. The number 11, judgment, disorder. The number 12, governmental perfection, the Gentile church and the Jewish church. The number 13, depravity and rebellion, the beast. Number 14, deliverance or salvation, multiplied, multiple of 7, it goes back to number 7. And number 15, rest, the sum of 8 and 7, the product of 3 and 5. Things can go back and forth between different points. Number 16 is love. 17 is victory. 18 is bondage. Number 19 is faith, sum of 10 and 9. Number 20, expectancy, 2 compounded by 10. Number 21, product of 7 and 3, fullness. Number 22, light, revelation, spiritual knowledge, 2 compounded and repeated. The number 30, multiplied 3 and 10, compounded of their meanings. The number 33, 3 compounded and repeated. The number 40, probation, testing, purification. The number 42, product 7 and 6, the number of completion. Number 40, compounded perfection, 7 times 7. The number 50, Holy Spirit, 5 compounded by 10. The number 55, 5 compounded and repeated. The number 60, pride. Number 66, the earthly house of God, 6 compounded and repeated. The number 70, compounded perfection, 7 times 10. Often numbers above 12 carry several different meanings, usually dependent on the context of the verse or chapter they are located in, or by the numbers they are compounded by, or by what they are the sum of. There is a lot more reason for 2 or more numbers to mean the same thing. It was too complicated to put in the message, but I can understand why. It cannot, at least for now, be proven every single number in the Bible has any great significance. Many are, however, finding out more and more of the mysteries of the scriptures in these last days. In no way should we omit or otherwise change any of the numbers found in the scripture. It is a mistake that should be avoided at all costs. The problem that many of the modern translations have is that they have, in many cases, changed usually by converting weights and measures into current standards, or by completely omitting a number altogether, replacing it with a dependent paraphrase. An example, John chapter 6, verse 5 to 7. Verse 5, and Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him. He saith unto Philip, whence shall we buy bread? What these may eat? Verse 6, he asked this only to test him, for he already had in mind what he was going to do. Verse 7, Philip answered, 200 penny worth of bread is not sufficient. Not sufficient for them, but every one of them may take a little. Now, in the NIV, the first two verses are the same. The third one, verse 7. It says, Philip answered him, 8 months wages would not buy enough bread for each one to have a bite. Notice the difference between this and its corresponding verses for the NIV. Verses 5 and 6 are the same, but 7 is changed. The King James Bible, Philip says, 200 pennies. In the NIV, it was changed to 8 months wages, and instead of not sufficient for them, the NIV says, do not buy enough bread for each one to have a bite. Not only has the number been, but a paraphrase interpretation has taken its place. Various numeral codes. In this last section, there is this assortment of various numerical patterns that are contained only in the King James Bible. Number 3. Number 3 is the number of divine completion and resurrection. 3 is the number of the Godhead. It should be mentioned that the term Trinity is not a Bible term. The only term used to describe the persons of God is the word Godhead. 1 John 5:7 declares to us that there are 3 persons in the Godhead, unless you have an NIV. So it comes as no surprise that the word itself, Godhead, is found only 3 times in Scripture. 1 John 5:7. For there are 3 that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. These 3 are one. Since the number 3 is the number for resurrection, it would stand to reason that it would be associated with being born again. It is the phrase that Jesus himself used to describe salvation. Born again is found exactly 3 times in the AV, and each time it is the reference to the number 3, either in chapter or verse. John 3:3, Jesus answered and saith to them, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. The King James Bible, God's holy word, is a fountain of information that would take so too many years to know all the words and numbers. I pray this message helps someone learn a little more about the King James Bible. I got most of the information that I use in this message from the internet. I only go to the King James Bible source to find it. There's no better place to read about God than the King James Bible, his true words. Heavenly Father, thank you for this.